Less than a setback, we can can now tell you that these were all true. And it is my pleasure to introduce you to the two gentlemen who now own the Opera Populaire, Monsieur Richard Biermann and Monsieur Gilles André. But gentlemen, Signora Carlotta Giulicelli, now leading soprano for 5 seasons now.
Oh, of course, of course. I have experienced all your greatest roles, Signora.
And Signor Ubaldo Pianchi.
An honor, Signor.
If I remember rightly, this has a rather fine aria in Act 3 of Hamlet. I wonder, Signora, if as a personal favor you would oblige us with a private rendition. Unless, of course, we shall really object.
Oh, my manager commands. Monsieur Ray.
My diva commands.
Would 2 bars be sufficient introduction?
2 bars would be quite sufficient.
Signora.
Maestro.
She has been well taught.
Very well.
Oh, well, that's
the beginning of the act.
I knew your secret. Thank you. crying shadow I hide. Look at your face in the mirror.
Thank you. Thank you.
Those two fools around my theater will be missing you.
Success. We were hardly bereft when Carlotta left.
Otherwise, the waltz was enchanting, the dancing was a lamentable
mess. Dear Fibber, just a brief reminder, my salary has not been paid. Send in care of the ghost, a return of post, P-E-T-O. No one likes a debtor, so it's better if my orders are obeyed. Who would have the gall to send this? Someone will get your mild brain. He's a ghost, like a king. Who the hell is he? Not the ghost. It's really not amusing.
He's abusing opposition.
In addition, he wants money.
He's a funny sort of spectre.
He says a lot of pain, a lot of pain. He is clearly
dead. Where is she?
Hear me call.
And Miss Dunny, where is she?
But how should we...
What an answer. I take it that you sent me this note.
What's all this nonsense? Of course not.
So look at her. She's not with you then.
Of course not. We're in the past.
Monsieur, don't argue. Isn't this the letter you wrote?
And what is it that we meant to have wrote? Written. Of fearful time, the angel of music has her under his wing. Make no attempts to sleep again.
Well, if you didn't write it, then who did?
Oh, no, 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 yes,
no, 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 no,
no, no, no, no, no, no, no,
no, no,
no, little bit I'd rather be seen.
And did you send it?
Of course not.
Yes, if you were, you didn't send it.
Of course not.
What's going on?
Dare to tell me that this is not the letter you sent.
And what is it that I meant to have sent? Your days at the opera popular numbered. Christine's eye will be seen on your behalf tonight. Be prepared for a great misfortune. Should you attempt to take
far too many notes for my taste, and most of them about Christine. All we heard since we came is Miss Dyer's name.
Miss Dyer has returned.
In which case I think our meeting is adjourned, precisely as you know.
I thought it best that she went home.
She needed rest.
May I see her?
Monsieur, she will see no one.
Will she sing? Will she sing?
Here, I have a note.
Let me see, please!
Gentlemen, I have now sent you several notes of the most amiable nature, detailing how my theatre is to be run. You have not followed my instructions. I shall give you one last chance.
Christine Dyer has returned to you, and I am anxious her career should progress in the new production of Immortal. You will therefore cast Carlotta as the page boy and put Miss Dyer in the role of Countess. The role which Miss Dyer plays calls for charm and appeal. The role of the page boy is silent, which is like casting in a word. I did. As you watch the performance from my normal seat in box 5, which will be kept empty for me, should these commands be ignored, a disaster
beyond your imagination will occur. I remain, gentlemen, your obedient servant, O.G.
Christie! Christie!
Christie!
Whatever that
is, all a point of hope, Christie!
This is insane!
You almost said this, the people to never be deep. Can you believe this?
Signora, and this is the devil's face, Signora!
I'm always willing!
Signora!
The man is mad!
We don't take orders!
This guy will be playing the page boy, the silent role!
Carlotta will be playing the lead! You don't think so, huh?
It's useless to my little
thing! A minister!
A minister!
A minister! A
minister!
A minister! A minister! A minister! A minister! A
minister! A minister! A
minister! A minister! A
minister! A minister! A minister! A
Signora, will you sing too?
I will sing your song.
Yes, I will.
you're to know the world wants you. Prima donna, first lady of the stage, your devotees are on their knees to implore you. When they shout your name, think of how they all adore. Prima donna, enchant us once again, and think of the news and of the news round the theater.
Made with you.
me.
The old fool is leaving.
I suspect my young Brand is untrue to me. I shall not leave, but shall hide over there to observe.
Ah! here.
Take me back there.
You must return.
Look at me. His eyes will find me there.
This is what I say.
Those eyes that burn empty. He has to kill a thousand men.
Don't get this way.
The phantom of the opera.
Phantom is a fable. There is the phantom of the opera.
My God, who is this man? Wants to kill.
This monster of death.
I can't escape from him.
This voice
I
hear.
Never will.
Ever.
And in this labyrinth, where night flies above, the opera is here. Inside my mind,
there is no phantom of the opera.
Brown, I've been dissolves into darkness, darkness. Look, I see him. Can I ever forget that sight? Can I ever escape from that face so distorted, deformed, its hardy face, in that darkness? To hold me and to
one love, one lifetime. Let me lead you from your solitude. Say you'll meet with you here beside me. Anywhere.
Love you, and we are.
Monsieur André.
Yeah.
Dear André, what a splendid party!
The privilege of
quite a night, I'm impressed.
Well, one does one's best. Here's to us,
a toast to all the city.
Such a pity that the
phantom can't be here!
Thank you.
why so silent, good monsieur? Did you think that I had left you for good? Have you missed me, good monsieur? I have returned you at opera. Here I bring the finished score. Don Juan triumphant. I advise you to comply. My instruction should be clear. Remember, there are worse things than a shattered chandelier. Your chains are still mine. You will sing for me.
Haven't you?
I know what I've seen. Please don't ask me, Monsieur.
Madame! For all our sakes!
Very well. It was years ago. I was a travelling fair in the city. Tumblers, conjurers, human oddities.
Go on.
And there was. I shall never forget him. A man locked in a cage.
In a cage?
Prodigy, Monsieur. Architect, musician, and an inventor too, Monsieur. They boasted he had once built for the Shah of Persia a maze of mirrors.
Was this man?
A freak of nature, more monster than man.
Deformed?
From birth, it seemed.
Oh, my God.
Then he went missing. He escaped.
Run!
I never found him. It was said he had died.
Did he?
The world forgot him, but I never can. For in this darkness,
so,
I have seen him
this
again.
Man.
I have said too much,
no, wait,
too much. And there have been too many accidents.
Accidents? Madame Shiri!
Ludicrous, have you seen the score?
Simply ludicrous!
It's the final straw.
This is ludicrous!
The writing of some lunacy.
I can't refuse.
Not about the chandelier.
Look,
my friend, what we have here, please. A dear, I'm drinking my orchestration. We need another first bassoon. Every note's overblown, and the trombone has to go. The man can't be deaf, so he's preferably one who plays in tune.
Yeah, fear them vis-a-vis my opera.
Some chorus members must be sacked.
If you could find out which has a sense of pitch,
wisely, no. I managed to assign a rather minor role to those who cannot have it.
I'm not to rage!
What is it now?
This whole affair is I'm not to rage!
Signora, please! Now what's the matter?
Have you seen the size of my part?
It's an insult! But he was worse!
Just look at this! It's an insult!
Please understand!
I see you, Signora!
The things I have to do for my art!
If you can call this gibberish art!
Ah, here is our little flower!
Ah, Miss Daly, quite the lady of the hour!
Secure the largest role in this star.
Christine, darling, she doesn't have the voice!
Signora, please!
Then I take it you're agreeing.
She's behind this!
Yes, we had no choice!
She's the one behind this! Christine, darling, how dare you!
I'm not a fool, evil woman, how dare you!
You think I'm wise?
Is it my fault? I don't want any part in this plot!
Besides, you're your mum's wife! When does she say you're a fitted butterfly?
She's back in there!
You have a duty!
I cannot say it! Duty or not!
Christine, you don't have to. They can't make you.
Please, monsieur, another note. Fond is greetings to you all. A few instructions just before rehearsal starts. Carlotta must be taught to act.
not the normal trick of strutting round the stage. Our Don Juan must lose some weight. It's not healthy in a man of Yankee's age. And my managers must learn that their place is in an office, not the arts. As for Miss Christmas, I beg, no doubt she'll do her best. It's true, her voice is good. She knows, oh, should she wish to excel, she has much skill to learn. If my dream returns to her teacher,
an angel. I can't. I won't do it.
We have all been right. And yet the answer is staring us in the face. This could be the chance to ensnare our clever friend.
Where's the door?
Shall play his game. Form his work, but remember your gaze. For if Miss Dye sings, he is certain to attend.
We make certain the door is upon. We make certain our men.
Make certain the armed.
The curtain falls. His ready will end.
Mary!
I'm not so sure.
Not
if it works.
Mary!
The time will turn.
But you believe me, there is no way of turning the time.
You stick to ballet.
Then help us.
Monsieur, my father.
Instead of warning us.
Help us.
I wish I could.
Don't make excuses.
That you're on his side.
She's a compass.
Believe me, I am too ill, Carpenter. Be careful, he has seen.
But
see
him for the poor.
Be careful, he has seen.
This time!
silken couches he threw back, of hanging his battle fleet.
Does a dangle with the war?
No! Chorus, rest, please. Good one. Signor Bianchi, this is the phrase. Don't dangle with the one, you please.
Does a dangle with the war?
Merry but men!
The man, man! Does a death, death, death with a
moan! Yes, praise, Ben. At least he make it sound like music.
Signor! Would you speak that way in the presence of the composer?
The composer is not here. And if he were here,
I would be certain of that! Signor.
So, once again, if you please, Signor. After seven. Five, six, seven.
Lots of candle with the moon.
Oh, the worst of what is it had to the old priest. No one would know if it is a right or wrong. No one would care. But no sultan will be there. You are one.
Are the doors secure? Secure! I'm here.
I'm here!
Oh, idiot, I said only when the time comes!
No buts.
For once, Monsieur le Vicomte is right. Seeing my fate tonight, I hate to have to cut the fun short. But your cheeks wearing thin, let me not hear and sin, let my opera
Dreamless end. What
the fire that glowed. What unspoken secrets
more of the sin of the wickedness of my abhorrent face.
loved by everyone, met with hatred everywhere, no kind word from anyone, no compassion anywhere. Crispy, why? Why?
Come on, come on, come on.
you try my patience. Make your choice.
Pitiful creature of darkness, what kind of life have you known? God, give me courage to show you.
So the world will never find you.